Ball is here, and he has a message for the president. Mr. Ball, thank you for taking the opportunity.
No problem.
Did you ever think that you would be on CNN discussing geopolitics and the president of the United States?
Never in my wildest dreams.
So, as we live this dream, let's discuss how we got here. Your son was with UCLA. They're playing ball over in China. They get detained with allegations that they stole merchandise from a store. The president finds out about it. He, of course, is in China. He's meeting with President Xi. He gets involved. The boys are released. They get to come back home, which was never a certainty until he got involved. He says that
how do you know it wasn't involved before I even knew that? I mean, he didn't even know they was over there and like that. Okay, what was the reason for him going over there in the first place?
The president was in China to meet with the president of China and discuss trade matters, but he certainly was informed
and that's
about
before
the boys when he was in China, and that's why he got involved, he says.
Okay, he didn't get involved till he got to China?
I don't understand your question.
So he wasn't going over there beforehand?
He was going over there
beforehand.
What are you trying to say?
What
are you trying to say?
It wasn't like he was in the U.S. and said, okay, there's three kids in China. I need to go over there and get them.
Okay.
That wasn't a thought process.
All right. Okay. Right.
What we're talking about right now is a lot of stuff about my son just because his last name is Ball. We're not even talking about the other two kids.
Well, to be honest, we're talking about your son.
Thank you.
We're talking about your son.
I'm talking about my son, too.
Right, but we're talking about your son because of you and what you said. This isn't picking on your son. It's because of how you inserted yourself into this and seemed to disrespect the president's efforts.
It's when somebody asks me a question. That's not disrespectful if I feel nobody did anything. I don't have to say go around saying thank you to everybody. I mean,
you don't have to go around saying thank you to everybody.
I didn't shake his hand. He didn't have to say that, but I'm just saying. If I have to know what somebody's doing before I say thank you. I'm just not going to go around saying thank you.
All right, so let's...
Now, you come and shake my hand and meet me or meet my son or anybody and then say, you know what, maybe I can help you out.
Let's
do it that way. But just because people say things, you know, it's supposed to be true, like, hey, I stopped him from saving 10 years. Maybe we was doing some talking with some other people before he even got there. So I'm saying... There's a lot of other matters to go around for the president to deal with that's political.
All right, let's take one step back.
I mean, as far as me, let me deal with my son and let him do what he's going to do.
All right, Mr. Ball, let's take one step back because you seem to have doubts about what the president did. You said you were talking to people.
No, I don't have no doubts about what he did. I got doubts what he didn't do. How's that?
You have doubts not about what he did, but what he didn't do.
See, what I'm saying is, hey, I'm going to tell you this. If I'm coming to get you,
yes.
If I'm coming to get you, let's say I'm coming to get you out of trouble. If I'm coming to get you out of trouble, you best believe I'm going to take you with me. So if I come over here and say, excuse me, sir, whoever, can you do something for this kid or this person and allow me to take them with me? That's if I'm doing something for somebody.
All right, so
I'm not going to come over there.
Let's just
say,
get right to it.
So, let's be a little lenient on it, but I'm out of here.
All right, is what you're saying that because the president of the United States didn't bring the boys home with him, he therefore didn't do enough, or do you think he really didn't do anything?
I didn't say nothing about him. I didn't say nothing about him.
I know, but you're kind of like talking about him without saying his name. I'm just trying to clear up the confusion.
I mean, I'm coming back home, and I'm just saying anything. There ain't no confusion.
There's a lot of confusion.
It's just somebody asked me a question, and I gave us a lot of confusion to you.
It's a lot of confusion to me. It is. That's why I needed you on. Do you think the president helped?
Why is it confusing?
Because I don't understand what you're saying. I am concerned. Did you think that the president helped the boys get out?
That's because you have to listen very slowly, carefully.
I'm trying.
Did he help the boys get out? I don't know.
Why do you doubt it?
I don't know. If I was going to thank somebody, I'd probably thank President Xi.
President Xi.
I'll thank him. He's in China. He's the head of the president in China.
True. And the president of the United States said that you should thank him.
Somebody can make a suggestion. Somebody can make a suggestion, and somebody could do something. You got people that make suggestions. You got people that do things.
I just don't understand just your skepticism about it.
A lot of people be like, hey, why don't you be a little lenient? What is the skepticism about? Why are we even talking about this with all these political matters going on in the world?
Well, but this is the one that concerns your
involvement. Somebody's going to go and tweet, and my involvement is always going to be with my son, but I don't have to deal with everybody around me.
I understand.
I just got to make sure he's taken care of.
But the president.
But there's a lot of people that can go around and say, LaVar, this is what I did for your son. I did this for your son. I did this. He'd never be where he was if I didn't do this for him. I'm not trying to hear all that.
I know, but there's
I'm just
a
saying,
difference
when you go
between.
Over there, what are we talking about? We're
on,
talking
LaVar,
about.
There's a difference between
a president
some,
doing something for my son.
Yes, that's what we're talking about. We got it. Now we're on the same page.
Okay.
So the president.
What did he do for my son?
The president says that he spoke to the Chinese president. He says that the boys
okay,
were
that
informed.
Nice. That was nice.
That the involvement of the president of the United States mattered. And that then he wanted some thanks. And instead, you said, who? What was he, Trump, over there for? Don't tell me
he,
nothing.
He wanted some thanks.
Everybody wants to make it seem like
who?
He helped me out.
I mean, you're trying to make it sound like that. I'm just saying.
That's what you said.
I didn't meet Winnie face to face. I know exactly what I said, but you buffing it up like you said that you don't want to say thank you to nobody. No, come meet me
I
like
sound?
A man, shake
I was
my
trying
hand
to say
and tell
it much
me what
more
you've done
evenly
for me.
Than that. I was trying to be much more even. I don't want to. I'm not trying to add tone to it.
I know how you were trying to say it, but that's okay.
I'm trying
I know
to
you're
say
trying
with
to add
an
tone
even
to it. That's what you do.
No, no, no. What I try to do is try to figure out
tone.
What's going on, LaVar. Why would you push back on the president?
I mean, you can open your eyes and see what's going on. I'm not saying nothing to the president. I'm not just saying thank you to anybody for nothing. I'm just saying I had some things done. I talked to some people that did some other things, too.
Ooh.
And then, like I said, people trying to, it doesn't matter.
It does.
I mean, it's not big names like you're thinking of. So, like I'm saying, people are saying that I said it wasn't a big deal that my son was shoplifting and nothing like that. I'm saying like this, it wasn't a big deal because being raised in South Central LA, I've seen harsher things. I've seen 16 to 17 year old kids have to go to jail for life that were my friends, doing bad things, making bad decisions. I mean, doing stuff that's harming people.
Right, but do you understand why when people see these allegations and you say it's not a big deal?
He wasn't physical. We returned it. He fessed up to it. It wasn't like he was like, nah, I didn't take him. I mean, nobody got hurt. He didn't run in there with the assumption of, hey, I can't wait till I get to China because I'm going to get some good stuff. It was an impulse thing, a bad decision at a bad time. That's all it was. For an 18-year-old who'd never done anything wrong, never been late to class, 4.0 student, I don't think people were going to demean him over one bad decision concerning that it was victimless. He didn't grab nobody's arm. He didn't do nothing. He tried to slide something away, understood what he did, but it's not going without punishment. But I don't think you should come down on a kid for making one mistake like that at 18 years old. That's why
I
thought
things
would be
okay. I don't think that what we're seeing in the coverage of this is that the boys are being demonized for what they did. There's no question that there are much worse crimes than shoplifting.
It doesn't matter.
But shoplifting does matter. And in China, you go to jail for it.
It's just like people said in China. But listen, you go to jail.
In fact, you could go to jail here for it.
And you get caught. People try to make, exactly, they try to make it a big deal like they're saying.
Well, it is kind of a big deal.
You shoplift
in
China.
You can go to jail.
Boy, that's big time. You going to jail. You can go to jail anywhere you take anything. So that's the point that shouldn't even be said.
I know, but
it's
in China,
if you got something and you want it, you shouldn't just go and steal
it. Hold on
it.
A second.
You can go to Africa or somewhere and do the same thing. Anywhere you go in somebody else's country, yes, it's going to be a little deeper than what you thought it was.
All right.
And that's a fine thing, but we already got that point across.
All right. So let's put the boys aside. We know what they did. You say that they apologized.
Okay.
That's good. Now,
right. Yes.
They were in a place that didn't need to let them go. And they could have been held for a long time.
They were in a place
time.
That didn't let him go. He
didn't
said he
need
got him out of jail,
let them
right?
Go.
He said, you heard what he tweeted. He tweeted, because he's mad at me, I should have left the asses in jail. First of all, they wasn't in jail. They was in a hotel. Now, how'd they get to the hotel on bail?
Somebody did you make that happen?
Something. Somebody had to do something.
Did you do it?
I'm just telling you, somebody had to do it. Did he do it?
I'm asking you, did you do it?
I'm asking you, did he do it?
He says he helped get them out of China.
Okay, if he paid for the money to put up whatever we needed to do, then I would say thank you. Did he do that?
So that's the bar? If he doesn't put up bail for the boys, then he doesn't deserve thanks? Come on.
No, it's not if he didn't put up bail. He said he helped. How'd he help? If he helped, I would say thank you.
He says he spoke to the president of China and that was relayed to
you
and the boys, that you were told that he helped.
So anybody who speaks to the president, I should thank anybody who speaks to the president?
No, but this is the president of the United States who spoke to the Chinese president. That's not just anybody. You know what kind of power he has. I don't get why you're hiding from this.
Who's just not anybody?
I don't get why you're ducking this, to be honest with you.
Why would I hide from nothing?
I don't understand.
If I was ducking this, I wouldn't even be here talking to you. Well, yeah, you seem like I'm ducking, but I don't duck nobody. That's why I'm sitting here talking
around
it.
You're talking around it.
Because you don't understand it.
Why couldn't you just say thank you to the president? Your son said thank you.
Why are you talking around it?
I'm talking right at it.
How much intel do you have on the situation? Were you there?
I was not there.
I can't hear you. Okay, then. Unless you were there, then you can talk to me.
You can hear.
I was there.
You don't have to be there.
I was there in China.
I understand.
I know you weren't there, though. But you see,
But hold on a second. LaVar Ball, you were there, but you don't know.
I was there.
I know you were.
I do know what I did.
Do you think the president helped?
Okay.
Do you think the president helped?
Do I think the president helped?
Yes.
I don't know.
So do you think he would be lying about helping?
You can say what you want. I didn't see him talk. I don't care, and I don't know. I wasn't there. I'm not going to say nothing I don't know, and I don't see, and I don't hear.
So the president of the United States says he helped, and you say if you didn't see it, you didn't hear it, you don't believe it.
Hey, if he said he helped, that's good for his mind.
What do you mean good for his mind?
I mean, but why I even got to say that? If you help, you shouldn't have to say anything. If you help, you shouldn't have to. If I help somebody, I don't walk around saying, you know, I help you now. Come on now, you give me some love. I helped you. Man, come on, for real?
All right.
Somebody told me about the tweet a couple of days ago. I don't even tweet. I'm just saying, why is that on your mind? All this stuff going on, and that's on your mind that a father didn't say thank you? And you're supposed to be the head of, you know, you're the head of the U.S.? Come on.
Okay, fair
We're
criticism.
Not even talking about
what
the
I'm president doing. Is asking for thanks. You can criticize that. Should
what
he be doing that?
Should
about he not
that?
Be doing
that? I'm just stating a point that I'm saying is, there's a lot of other things that's going on,
No
man.
Question about
let
it.
Let him do his political affairs and let me handle my son, and let's just stay in our lane.
But he thinks that he did something for the boys and he should be thanked, and
okay,
instead you took
if
a shot
thinks
at him.
It, that's fine. If he thinks it, I ain't took a shot at him.
You did.
Somebody asked me a question, man. I gave him my opinion, but I ain't taking no shot at the president for
it
what?
It sounded like you were taking a shot like at that. The president. It sounded like it.
Hey, I mean,
it did.
You can
I'm just
sound
being
like
honest
that because
you
want it to be like that, but it's not. But why would it sound like that? That's
well,
because you want to take it that way so
no,
you can have some news
it's
and
what
I can
you
get
said,
on here and
it's
talk
because
to you and keep you going.
You won't say thank you. Hey, thanks. Your son said thank you. The other guy said thank you. So you say thanks. Thanks for helping me.
I'm not the other guys, though. I'm not the other guys. I'm doing something else. I'm not the other guys.
What do you see? I agree with you. You're not
so
the other guys.
I know,
I think
I know
you
you're trying to rile something up. And
no,
that's
I
okay.
Think you
that's
are.
Part of your job.
I think
but, you know,
you
I don't get
are.
Easily tussled like that.
I think you are. I think
I'm
you're
what?
Very
what
clever.
I
see your big smile
are
on
you
your face.
Are you going to say thank you to me?
I'm
going to
say thank
you
at the end of this interview. I will thank you. I guarantee
no.
it.
No. Are you going to say thank me now?
I guarantee it. You know why?
Are you going to thank me now?
You know why?
Are you going to thank me now?
Not yet. You haven't earned it yet.
Why are you going to thank me?
Haven't earned it yet.
But no. Why are you not going to thank me?
Haven't earned it yet.
Why are you going to thank me right now?
When
you
earn
like the
it,
word
I'll
thank
you. We're still
like
short on
thank you?
We're still short. Your son
what?
Said thank you,
you can say
for
thank
helping
you. Can
him
you
get
say
out
thank
of
you,
China.
Mr. LaVar Ball?
I will
can
thank you
Can you say
at the
thank
end
you, Mr. LaVar
interview.
Ball, for having this?
Listen.
How about we do it now? I just want to hear it.
You know what? I'll show you what.
I just want to hear it now.
Just to be decent, just because it's a nice thing to do,
yeah.
Mr. Ball,
oh,
thank you
now
for being
it's a nice
here
thing
with
do,
me
see?
On CNN tonight.
Oh.
Don Lemon thanks you
now, how hard,
from wherever
how,
he
how
is.
How hard was that?
And in fact,
now,
Don
why,
Lemon
why
should thank me
though?
For talking to you on his show right now.
Hey,
he
why,
owes me
why
thanks.
Are you thanking me, though, just so, to say thank you?
Wait, hold on. Will you
I'm
thank
just saying,
me
why
back?
Are you thanking me? Give me a couple of reasons.
Will you thank me
give
back
Give me a couple
first?
Of reasons why you thanking me.
First, thank me back.
I'm just asking. Give me a couple of reasons. I got to know why you just thanking me. You just can't say thank you,
you
and thank
you.
You
took time
to
be on
be
this
telling
show.
Me to be quiet.
There are other things you could
but
have
I'm,
done.
But I'm just saying. Yes.
That's why I'm thanking you.
And, but you, come on.
But
and that's why you're thanking
it
me.
It doesn't
come
take
on
much
now.
To say thank you. Why won't you say thank you to the president?
It doesn't make. Well, if somebody does something for you, then you say thank you.
Somebody did
now,
something for
that's
you.
That's your opinion
say
that
thank
he's
you.
Done for me? Okay. I would say thank you if he would have put him on his plane and took him home. Then I would have said, thank you, Mr. Trump, for taking my boys out of China and bringing them back to the U.S. There's a lot of room on that plane. I would have said, thank you kindly for that.
So because he
but
didn't take them home on the plane,
say,
no thank you.
Well, I'm just saying, that's how I would say thank you. I'm just saying, you might say thank you a different way. You just say thank you like it's
no,
just
you,
any kind
it's
of
It's not
word.
How you'll
you
say thank
you.
It's
your thank
when
you.
You'll
I can,
say
I can tell,
thank you.
I can tell you don't mean nothing about it.
That's not true. When I say thank you, I mean it.
You change back and forth.
I mean it.
Well, hey, don't get so excited
when
now.
When I say
hey,
thank
you, mean
I mean
like
it.
That. Come on.
I mean it. When I say thank you, I mean it.
No, you don't. No, you don't. You know how I can tell?
Tell me.
You know how I can tell?
Tell me.
I ain't gonna tell you because I'm gonna let you figure it out on your own. I got you.
That was good. I'll give you that.
A little laughter never hurt nobody.
But with me,
a little laughter never hurt nobody, man.
One thing. With the President of the United States, I think you are enjoying this back and forth.
But my question is,
are you worried you've taken on too big an opponent?
Let me ask you this question. He's not an opponent because I don't know Trump like that. I haven't done nothing to him. He hasn't done anything to me. So I don't consider him an opponent. I just consider him a human being and the President of the United States.
That's his title. All of that is true.
My title is LaVar Ball, the big baller, the CEO of the big baller brand. We just got our titles like that. But we still both men and we both human. But I'm not going to go out and be like, if a person doesn't say something to me or for me, I'm not going to tweet. I'm not going to do all that.
But you
for
do.
What? I mean, is it that do, big
you,
of a deal?
You do feel.
But is it that big of a deal, though?
I think
I'm just
that
asking, is that,
it is
that big of a deal?
If it's a huge deal. Because the president responded,
now,
and it seems like you're in a little bit of a war of words with the most powerful man in the world.
Why would I be in war with a guy with the most powerful man in the world?
That's my question. Why would you take on Donald Trump after he helped your kid?
I don't know. What do you mean, take on Donald Trump? Take on him for what? What are we doing for each other?
That's a good question. I know what he did for you.
What are we doing for each other?
And instead of saying thank you,
what did he do for
you
me?
Took a shot at him.
What did he do for me?
He helped get your son out of China, where he could have been in jail for a long time.
What about some other? Why was he going to be in jail for a long time?
Because he stole something, according to the Chinese authorities.
How long did you think he was going to be in jail for?
Could have been a long time.
Okay, but
carries
the Chinese
a minimum
authorities
of 3 years.
Was like, you know what? He's okay. He has so much character in 18 years that he's allowed to have a pass for that.
That's your son.
One bad decision at a time.
And he said thank you to the President of the United States, something his father didn't want to do. What kind of example does that give your son?
Is that to my son? I'll tell you what type of example it is. You know where my boy's at right now? Because of me. Because I spent all that time and love for him. Don't come in one time and think you did something for my son. He's 19, about to be 19 years old.
It's a big one time, though, if he's in jail in China. It's not like he's some AAU coach saying, I taught him how to come off the pick.
Is he in jail?
You know?
Is he in jail?
Not anymore.
I taught him how to be exactly how he is, a respectful young man. That's what he is.
You think you're being respectful to the President of the United States?
You can't find no bad stuff about him.
You think you're being respectful to the President?
I haven't said anything bad about him.
Yeah, you did.
Yes, most definitely. I am. Yeah.
You said who?
I ain't said nothing.
What was he over there for? Don't tell me nothing. Everybody wants to make it seem like he helped me out. Disrespectful.
Like I said, if somebody's talking to me, don't tell me nothing. I don't like people talking to me. When I say don't tell me nothing, that means just leave me alone. That means stay in your lane. Leave me alone. Let me go my way, you go your way. That's what it means. Now, you're taking it to a whole different level. You act like you. What's your last name?
Cuomo.
Are you Trump's brother? You want me to thank you?
You don't
That's
have to
That's what I'm saying.
Me.
You kind of adamant about
get,
this.
I didn't
like
get your son out of jail in China.
Level.
You don't have to thank me. I didn't get your son out of jail.
But how many people how many people put their sources together to get him out?
I don't know. You tell me.
Maybe
I keep asking you. You won't answer.
I'll tell you the things I do know he did. I know he apologized and wrote a sincere letter. I'm talking about my son.
Your son did the right thing in the situation in terms of apologies. Nobody's saying anything else.
Exactly. And that's what he does.
I know. It's
you
I'm talking about.
Don't worry about what's going on the outside. The people that's involved, those are the ones who have to be understanding of what's going on or who helped him or whatever like that.
Yeah, you're one of those people.
But me on the outside, no. I know I helped my son get out of China. How's that?
You think you helped more than the President of the United States?
I had some people that had boots on the ground that knew the situation when we first jumped on there. So I keep those people in mind.
You think you would have gotten him out of China without the President's help?
And best believe, I talked to enough people that I said thank you to, face to face.
So
they didn't come around. I tell you what, I say thank you when I see something. I don't thank you because just people because it's talking and say, I did this, I did that.
So if the president invited you to the White House, would you say thank you then?
Heck yeah, if he invited me to the White House, I would thank him for inviting me to the White House.
Would you thank him for getting your son out of China?
If he invited me to your house, I say thank you for getting me to your house. That's like how polite I am towards people.
But
if you invite me somewhere, and you do something nice to me, I'm going to say thank you.
I think you've made this
big
way more difficult than you need.
Thank you kindly, sir.
I think you've made this more difficult than you needed to, and you wound up provoking the president of the United States.
You know what? You making this more difficult. You know, LaVar didn't say thank you to the president.
You didn't.
So that makes me a bad person?
No, I'm just saying you didn't thank him.
Just swim on this?
And it doesn't make any sense why you won't thank
him. Did you thank the doctor for bringing you into this world? Well, you better go back and find him, because you're lucky. Yeah, look at
listen.
See, that's what I'm talking about. You need somebody like me to loosen you up a little bit.
You know,
you wound up tight.
I am. The president calls me chained lunatic.
See, is that what the president calls
you?
Yeah,
you and I are probably going to wind up in the same column in terms of people who get on the wrong side of the president.
But
I think you earned it.
No. We can't earn it like that. We didn't do nothing to nobody,
look,
man.
All I'm saying is,
we're both having a good time here and trying to get a little intellect. All I'm saying is, this is fun to you. I can tell.
Look, it's interesting.
But it's
give
okay.
You, that.
You know what?
LaVar Ball.
You know what? It's got to be interesting.
You make it interesting. I'll give
like
you that.
I like the way you keep saying my whole name, man. Hey, you know what? You can just loosen up and call me LaVar now. We've been on this thing
for a long time. I do feel like we've gotten to know each other. I'm going to be honest. I do
don't
feel
you
we got
like
a little bit
comfortable
of a bond
now? Just say, hey, LaVar.
A little bit.
Because you know I'm going to call you, hey, Chris.
You can call me
your
Chris
whole
whenever
name,
you want.
But
my friends
like
call
Chris,
me
man.
Mo. You can call me Mo if you want. I'll give you that.
Hey, why they call you Mo?
Cuomo.
I don't be having no alias, man.
Cuomo.
I don't know your real
That's
name.
Why.
I don't be talking about looking for Chris.
Deep.
And then they talk about, you talking about Mo.
It's not that deep, LaVar. It's Cuomo. That's all. Don't overthink
man,
it.
Man.
But here's what we learned.
Oh, that's where the Mo came from? Chris
yeah.
Mo?
Cuomo, not Chris Mo.
Hey, man. You
Cuomo.
Better...
LaVar, get your head straight.
Cuomo. Like Cuomo, like Google. Like the Google Chrome. I get it, Cuomo.
All right, that's it.
That's your hip-hop name in the hood, huh? I see how you get around.
LaVar Ball, thank you for coming on CNN tonight. I appreciate you taking the time.
Hey, Chris Mo, thank you for having me on here, man. I appreciate you. Cuomo.
I'm laughing
cool
at something else. I'm not laughing
hey,
at you.
I'll send you
that
some big baller.
That
I'll
was
send
too
you some
weak
big
a joke.
Baller merch.
Send it to me because
nice
it's too expensive. I can't afford
with the
it.
Big baller brown.
Send it on. We'll give it to charity.
I want to send you some stuff, man. I'm gonna send you some stuff. You can give it to charity. Put it around your neck, choking on your head. Do what you want.
LaVar
with.
Ball.
But it's your big baller gear, and you're gonna be a big baller forever.
LaVar Ball. The best to you and your family for Thanksgiving. The best to your boys and the best to your wife as well. Okay.
Hey, you have a great Thanksgiving. Hey, and I got a message for you.
What is it?
Tell Donald Trump to have a great Thanksgiving, because Big Baller is.
I hope you're thankful for him. Take care.
I'm thankful for everybody doing Thanksgiving. It's November.
Be well. Happy Thanksgiving. All right.
All right. Take care. Take care.
When we come back, President Trump has a lot on his plate. He's got North Korea. He's got the GOP tax bill. He's got Roy Moore. And he's got the big baller. So why in the face of all of that is the president dealing with the man who was just on your screen? We'll discuss it seriously when we come back.